हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ पूनम, पीजीटी कॉमर्स ऑफ टीएसएमएस दौलताबाद। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए चैप्टर फ्रॉम सोशल क्लास 10th। आई विल गिव यू सम हिंट्स टू गेस द चैप्टर। हियर इज द हिंट। आई होप यू आर गेटिंग ए आइडिया फ्रॉम दिस इमेज। एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड क्लू। यस, यू हैव गेस द चैप्टर राइट। इट्स migration. So let's first of all know what is actually migration. People moving from their birthplace to other place in search for the better opportunity is called migration. Means when people moves from one place to another place for something better. Something better means in search of some better job, in search of better education or something better opportunity. When they move from one place to another place, this is called migration. Migration arises out of various social, economic and political reason. To understand it better, let us move to the main reason of migration. Yes, this is the main reasons of migration. The first one is employment. Employment. Why the people are moving from one place to another place? In search of job, because everyone want money. To earning money, they move from one place to another place. The next one, education. For higher studies, for better education, people moves from one place to another place. The third one, family feuds. Means some family disturbance, family disputes, they move from one place to another place. Loss of business. Whenever the people are having loss, so for earning money, they move to the one place to another place. And the last one, marriages. Especially in the females, the marriages is the main reason of migration, because after marriage, they have to move from one place to another place. The next one, identification of migrant. How you will identify a person is migrant or not? For identifying a person as a migrant, two criteria are used by the census. The first one, birthplace. Birthplace means a place where the person was born. And the second one, last usual place of residence of place. Last usual residence place means where the person had stayed continuously for a period of 6 months or more. So with these two, birthplace and last usual place, or you can say present place, we can identify the a person is migrant or not. For example, one person who is belongs to Warangal and he is staying continuously in Hyderabad for more than 6 months, so he is a migrant. But if he stayed less than 6 months, he is not a migrant. The next one, rural to rural migration. Rural to rural migration is nothing when the people from one village moves to the another village. This is called rural to rural migration. A large sections of rural workers migrate for a short distance, particularly due to the distress caused by in the rural area. They are mainly agriculture laborer or marginal farmer in their place of origin and mostly belong to the low income household, Dalit and Adivasi. In agriculture sectors, mostly employees go to the native place of migrant and recruit them. How they will recruit them? With the help of contractor. Contractor is nothing, he is a mediator between a laborer and the owner. He will take benefit from the both labor as well as owner. So you can say a contractor sometimes work like a supervisor. He only hire the labor and he will only pay the money. He will take the money from the owner and he will give to the laborer. And totally why the rural to rural people migrate, mostly is a short term period, you can say for crops cutting, for seasonal. One season when they get the work, so they will move from one place to another place. The next one. In this pie chart, you can get an idea social background of short-term migrants in India in 2007 and 8. In 2007 and 8, you can say total 19% SC, 23% ST, and 40% OBCs, and 18% are others who migrate in 2007 and 8. The next one. Rural to urban migration. Rural to urban migration is nothing when people of rural area migrate to the urban area. People migrate from rural area mainly due to the insufficient employment opportunity and inadequate income available in the rural employment. So when employment opportunities are not sufficient in the village for earning more income, they move from rural to urban area. Most urban migrants have to work as a labor and find the employment in the unorganized sector. What is unorganized sector? Unorganized sector means when we don't have any rules, regulation, when we don't have any benefits. This is called unorganized sectors. So they could be working as a hawkers, painters, repair person, rickshaw puller, or construction labor, etc. People from rural area move to the cities and towns to work in the industries and other service activities. The next one, international migration. International migration is nothing but the outside the boundary of our country. When a people moves from one country to another country, this is called international migration. It is also two types. One is the skilled migrants and the second one is unskilled migrants. The first one is skilled migrants. Skilled migrants is nothing but the people who is having technical skill, who is professional expertise, like doctor, IT professional, management professional. When they migrate to the country such as USA, Canada, UK, Australia and other developed country, this is called skilled migrants. In recent time, Indian professional also go to the countries such as Germany, Norway, Japan and Malaysia, etc. So these all are coming under the skilled migrants category. The next one, unskilled or semi-skilled migrants. Unskilled and semi-skilled workers migrate to the oil exporting countries of the West Asia on a temporary contract. During the last few decades, Saudi Arabia and UAE have been the important destination for the most of the 3 million Indian workers in the West Asia. These workers are engaged in construction project, maintenance services, transport and telecommunication services. Nearly 3/5 of the workers going to the West Asia are from the Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Telangana and Andhra state. So what we can say, unskilled means they don't have any skill. When they don't have any skill, where they are going mostly in the West Asia, like oil exporting countries. What they will do there, they will do only the construction site work, maintenance work or telecommunication or labor work. These all are coming unskilled or semi-skilled migrants. The next one. What happens when people migrate? Means when people move from one place to another place, what are the favorable or what are the unfavorable effects? Let us see. The migrants have to spend more money on the food. Migrant laborers, they have to spend more money on the food as they cannot get the food grains from the fair price shop at their workplace. The next one, people have to live in a harsh and unhygienic condition. Thus, they suffer from the health problem and are prone to disease. Means when the peoples are when people move from village to city, they don't have the good working condition. They have to stay in a slum area. When they have to stay in slum area, definitely they will get the health problem. The next one, people working in the brick kilns, quarries, construction sites and the mines suffer from the body aches, sunstroke, skin irritation and lung disease. Many accidents also take place here as the employers do not follow the safety measures. So wherever the workers work, they don't get the good environment. So that's why they face these all health problem issues. The next one, migrants are not able to access the various health and family care program as they do not belong to the organized sector. Women migrants won't get the maternity leave. 1/3 of the household depend on the remittance sent by their migrant members. Remittance is nothing but when the someone goes to the another place, he will earn money, and what the money sent to the city to village, this is called remittance. Whenever the full family is not moving, half family is staying in the city and half family is staying in the village. So the person who work in a city, they send some money to for their family. This is called remittance. The next one. Immigration Act 1983. Immigration Act 1983 is nothing but it is the law made by the government for the person who is staying in the abroad. The Indian law governs migration and employment of the Indians in abroad. It lays out the condition to safeguard the interest of the worker migrating for the employment. Embassies are set up by the Indian government in different countries. Why? To follow the legal procedure, to protect the welfare of the international migrant, to take the action when migrant worker is not paid their salary, to take the action when the recruitment agent cheat the prospective workers in the foreign, when the abroad companies, when they cheat to the Indian workers, this act safeguard the interest of that workers. This is our Immigration Act 1983. So that's all for the today topic, migration. Be at home, stay safe, keep learning. Thank you.